Hi, Edward Boyter here, and this is a demo video of WP Central Hub. This is not a sales page video, so this is only for JV partners, so you can see what WP Central Hub is all about, and if you need a review copy, just let me know. WP Central Hub is a management plugin where you can manage all your sites, WordPress sites, from one location, and you don't have to log in and do things like updating WordPress one by one, but you can do it from one location. Of course, there's a lot more functions, and I will show you what it's all about in this small video. After you have installed the plugin and added a few sites, its main screen will look like this, and adding a site is just a matter of adding the name and the URL and installing the plugin, the child plugin, on the site that you want to manage, because it works in combination, and that's the only time that you have to install something on the management site. As an upsell, Mike and I have done for you install service, so for those customers from you that have 50 or more sites and don't want to do all those work as well, then we have them covered and we can install the child plugins for them. At the main screen, you see the manage sites, the bulk action, and a help section. Over here, this is for managing a site one by one specifically. And if you want to update the WordPress install, then you click the update icon over here. At this moment, those are all at 4.3, so this is the latest version. Settings. Over here you can change the basic settings from the site, for instance the main email address, the default role from a subscriber or new user, time zone and things like that. Plugins, you can upload and deactivate already plugins that are installed. Teams, you can change the team that is activated. In this case, Generate Press is activated, but I can easily activate another one or upload a new plugin, team, I mean, if I want to. Users, the same thing. I can edit, delete, or add a new user. And if you delete an administrator, make sure to add one if you still want to have an admin at your site. Links the same. You can edit, delete, or add a new link to your sites. And you can write a post or a page. And this is all done from one location. The beauty, of course, is in the bulk actions. So, for instance, if I click this one, update all sites to a new WordPress version, then if there was a site that was not 4.3 at this moment, then those would be updated. Install new plugins. This is the same. You select a new plugin. And then you select the sites that you want them on and click the add new plugin, and those plugins will be added. Same goes for install new teams. If you want to install a new team on some sites or all your sites, then just a matter of selecting the team, selecting the sites, click the add new team, and those sites will be getting the new team, and the team will also be activated. Write posts and pages, it's the same with the individual part, with one exception that you can, when you use a post or a page on several sites, you have the option for spinning, and there's in the manual an explanation and an example for what I mean with that, but I guess most of the people know what spinning means. It's creating a slightly different version of your text based upon what you enter. And entering it is done by this, and then the colon sign and then that, and one times it will be this and the other time it will be that, and it is done on random, so you can go crazy with spinning if you want, and it's all built in. Add links as well in bulk, and the users. This is very helpful if you've got, for instance, a new virtual assistant that you want to give access to your sites or a view of your sites. Then all you have to do is enter the details, select the role that you want that person to have, and then select the sites and add new user. And all those users, all those sites will have that new user. You can also click this, select this box, and then that user will be getting an email with all the new details for all the sites that you have added them. There's in the child plugin download part, and this is where you enter an API key and a time offset. This is, for instance, helpful if there's a difference in time, which sometimes happens over hosting accounts, and you need to reset that time to be exact the same, because in the communication between the main site and the sites that are managed, one of the security parts is the time, because a query is not unlimited, and I have built it in just like Amazon does, where it expires, so that is something that helps for that. Just something to show, I got over here the test 2 site with this team, and if we look, it's the generate press which is active. And if I want to set the default 2020 team as active, it's shown over here as being the active team on that site now. And if I refresh, you see indeed it's the new team. So this works very easy. It's in our opinion a very good plugin for anybody that has either a lot of sites for niche sites or whatever reason, or if they building a private block network and have their sites all over the place. WP Central Hub is unique in the sense that you can manage sites not only on one server, but it doesn't matter where they are hosted, so you can manage sites on different hosting accounts. It doesn't matter. So this is very easy, and Mike and I are convinced this is a good plugin, and we hope to see you on the leaderboards. And if you need anything, just let us know. Thank you very much.